In this video you learn to use the revolve, fillet, shell, create a new plane, loft and circular pattern. The first step to create this part, we will select the front plane and make this sketch, and here will be the midpoint. And the first thing that we'll make, we'll create a line here with 8 mm, and this line here with 20 mm. We have another line here and two arcs, one arc with 5 mm and the other with 14 mm. So let's create this. And this arc here, this point here, and this point, the distance is 55 mm. So open the fusion, go to create a sketch, select the front plane, select line, make a line here with 8 mm, another line here with 20, another line here, make an arc to this side and another arc here, go to sketch dimension, the distance here 55 mm, the radius here is 5, and the radius here is 14. And select a line. We will make this line here and this one. This line here has 30 millimeters of length. So close the sketch here, go to sketch dimension, the distance here 30 millimeters. Now finish the sketch and go to revolve features, the profile, this one, and the axis, select this line here and the angle 360 and press OK. Now we'll make this fillet here with 5 mm. So go to modify, select fillet, select this edge, 5 mm here, and press OK. Now we'll use the shell tool to make the solid hollow. The thickness is 3 mm and we need to remove this face here. So go to modify, select the shell, select this face, the distance here 3 mm, and press OK. And now we will create an offset plane. We will make a plane here. The distance between this plane and the midpoint 20 mm. So go to construct, select offset plane, select the top plane, the distance here 20 mm, and press OK. And go to create a sketch and select this new plane. I will hide this bar a little bit. And in this new plane, we will make this sketch. So we will create an arc with 31 millimeters of radius and another arc with 28. And we will create a line here. These two arcs is concentric with the center point, and the distance between this point here and this point here is 2.5 millimeters. And so let's create this. Go to create, select the arc, center point arc, make an arc here, the radius 31 millimeters, and create another arc here with 28 millimeters. And here, select a line, make a line here, and another line here. And select the construction line type, select this point here, and this point, select this point here, and this point. And here, go to constraints, and select midpoint, sorry, go to select line, construction line, make a construction line here with 31 millimeters. Now go to constraint, select the midpoint, select this arc and select this point. And go to sketch dimension, the distance here is 2.5 millimeters. And go to constraint again and select collinear. Select this line here and this one, this line here and this one. And here, finish this sketch. Now we will create this sketch here in the top face, in this face here. So go to create a sketch and select this face here. And here, let's create a line to this side. This line will have 21 millimeters of length, and we will create an arc here with 21 millimeters and another arc here with 19 millimeters and create this two line. The same thing that we make here. And the distance here is 1.5 millimeters. So let me hide the sketch tool and I will hide this body a little bit. Select line, a construction line. Make a construction line here with 21 millimeters. Now go to create and select the arc, center point arc, click here in the midpoint, 21 millimeters, make an arc here, remove the construction line type, and create another arc here with 19 millimeters. Let me move this dimension here. And here go to sketch dimension. The distance here is 1.5 millimeters. And go to constraint, select the midpoint, select this line and the center point here. And select line again, make a line here. And make a construction line here between this point and this point here, this point and this point here. Go to constraint, select collinear, select this two line and this two line here. And finish the sketch. We made this two profile. And see that in this sketch, this arc here is 1 millimeter more than this, 1 millimeter here. And this one, 31, is 1 millimeter here. So we will create a line rail here to guide the loft with 1 millimeter of distance between this face here. So let's create this and go to create a sketch and select the front plane and show the sketch one. Go to offset, no, sorry, go to create and select the project included project. Select this profile here and press OK, and go to offset, select this line here, the distance here is 1 millimeter, and press OK, and finish the sketch, hide the sketch one, and here go to show this body, and go to create, select loft, select this profile, and select this profile here and click here in rails, select this line here, the sketch 4. The operation here is cut and press OK. Now we need to make more of this around this body. It is 50, so go to create, select the circular pattern, the object type, select the features, the object, select the loft, and the axis, select this circle here, and the distribution here, select the symmetric angle, 360, and the quantity, 50, and press OK. And now save this file. The name here, I will call Japandi Vases. So save this file and click here in file, go to 3D print, export this, the object, select this, the format 3MF and press OK. Now I will open the Bamboo Studio. Go to create a new project and select here add Japase, Japandi vases, open this, go to slice plate, and print this file. So here we finish your exercise. Thanks for watching, subscribe my channel for more, and see you in the next videos. Bye bye.